Okay. Are you ready to roll?
Yep.
Juan, let me ask you first of all about your family. What a big, amazing, crazy family, huh?
Yes.
How many kids? How many grandkids?
I have 10 kids from age 19 to 40, and grandkids 11 going on 12.
Wow. So it's lively around here.
It's always lively, and we always celebrate something, you know, together, except my son in the military. He's always not available.
So what's it like on when you get everyone together? I'm guessing there's music and food. Tell me what it's like when everyone is.
Well, most of the time I'll be at work, and then all of us, and then after I'm done playing, I come here, they're all over here, and they're all just enjoying everybody and lots of food. And, you know, I could stay with them just for a short while, and then I have to go back to work. But I always enjoy my family, spending time with them, you know, as much as I can, although I couldn't because I have to work day and night. But now, since I don't work at Norsum, so I have more time for them, you know, during the day.
Let's talk about work and your feelings about work and the need to work. Mm-hmm. Why is it important?
Well, we came here with nothing at all, you know, and we have 5 children when we came here to the United States. Actually, we don't have any relatives who can help us at all, except the cousin of my wife. I have to stay at her house, sleep in a couch, and I don't have the necessary clothing that I have. So I have to work hard for my family. And but God is so good to me. God blessed me with the right people to contact. Like when we went to church at Holy Rosary, the sisters invited the children to attend school at Holy Rosary without any tuition fee that I had to pay. They provided uniforms for the children. I don't have a job that time, but they still accepted us. And then they recommended me. They told me about Norsum, and so my wife called Norsum, and that time they were hiring musicians, you know, during the holiday. And I had an audition, and I passed the audition. I did not expect that I will be hired, but they still hired me.
Can we ask them to? Your work made your family and your home and
well,
all of that possible.
First, I put my trust in God, and then everything comes up, you know. And of course, you have to work hard. You have to practice every day. You have to be nice with everybody, and you know, that makes up everything, you know.
You've sort of lived what we call the American dream, haven't you? You came here, you said, with nothing?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And made something?
Made something. I don't know how I made it or how I did it, but it seems that, you know, miracles happen.
If there's enough hard work.
Yeah.
That helps, right?
Yes.
Tell me about, if I can ask you about your relationship with music, what it means to you.
well, now I feel different about music, you know, not like before that I have to force myself to work hard, you know. Because of our situation, you know, I have to work hard, and that's my first aim, to support the family. I enjoy playing the piano because the people around me are so nice that I was inspired to play well, be nice with them, smile at them, because they are all nice. So that helped me to love what I'm doing, playing the piano. There's a lot of people who gave me inspiration and encouragement, and I gained confidence in what I'm doing. It's just like you know where you're going. Not like before that I don't know what will happen, you know, if I'll be accepted here in America, or if I'll do a good job, they will like me. I don't know about that, but I experienced that everybody here was so nice to me, and so I got more inspired to work and enjoy my job, you know. Now I feel that I'm enjoying my job, and I feel the love of everybody. So
how do you want to get your feelings to go through your fingers?
Well, I love every melody that I play, you know, and I express my emotion and feelings in playing the piano. And, you know, I could hear music from my brain, and then the expression that that is in my heart, and lots of people inspires me. My family inspires me, and that's how I do it. And
is there emotion that comes out through your music and through your playing that you could never speak?
Yeah, most of the time. Yeah.
Talk about that.
When I
that's hard,
can you
isn't
tell
it?
Me, that's can hard. You tell me some specific
well
things?
Are there I've always wondered, like someone like you, are there things that you would have trouble talking about but that you can play, and that feeling instead of
trouble talking about.
If there's something, you know, I don't know, sadness or anger or something like that, but maybe you don't speak about it, but it comes through your piano playing. Maybe not.
Well, sometimes, you know, when people are in a bad mood or something, just like one time I was playing the piano. There was a man, he's an older man, and I think he's a little bit drunk, and then he wants me to play a certain music, and I told him, I'm sorry, I don't know that song. What he did is close the lid of the piano and bang it almost to my hands, but I did not get mad at him. And then I played another song, and then he came back to me, and he said, "That's what the song I want you to play." I don't know if it's lying or what, but I played with my whole heart, and I just smiled at him when he left. When after he banged the cover of the lid of the piano, you know, and I almost got hurt. You know, he was really in a bad mood.
Maybe a little bit of this. Huh?
Yes, and then I didn't mind him. I played again. I played some song.
What does it feel like when you're playing? When you're really going good and it's music you love, what does it feel like to you?
As if I'm playing for the whole world, that it's like I want to express my feeling that the world is wonderful in spite of all the problems that we're having. It's still a wonderful world, and I wish there's peace among everybody, and love, peace and love among people.
That's the feeling.
Yeah.
It's got to be a good feeling.
Yeah, I just concentrate on my piano playing, and I put my full expression, and I think that no matter what problems you might have, you know, I express it through my music, that there's always hope. You know, don't give up. Life is wonderful, or we just have to do the best we can and trust in God.
That's awesome. Want to tell me about your illness?
My illness, it's not curable. That's what the Seattle Cancer Care Alliance told me. There's no cure for that kind of cancer. It's called synovial sarcoma. And I might live only for 6 months. And so, but as I told you, I put my trust in God already, I do the best I can. I don't know if that is true, that I'll just live for the next 6 months, and so I don't know what to do. I don't know what to expect in the future, but I have my faith in God. Everything will be all right.
Are you frightened?
A little bit. I'm not ready to die. But if he calls me, you know, I just have to accept reality. I have to accept the truth. But for now, you know, I'm aware about that already, and I accepted it.
So tell me about your decision to keep working.
I enjoy my job right now. I enjoy everybody, both the customers and my coworkers. They are all wonderful to me. My supervisors are all wonderful to me. And I'll continue working, you know, as long as I can, you know.
Did you ever consider just saying, boy, in light of what's going on, I think I'm just gonna stop playing?
No.
Why not?
Because I don't want to feel like, I don't want to waste my time, you know. If I could still do something, you know, why shall I quit and wait for my death? So I'll continue working and playing and volunteering until I cannot make it anymore, you know.
Wow, that's pretty amazing, Juan.
Yeah, that's what I want to do. I'll never give up.
You play with your son accompanies you on guitar when you play the marimba.
The marimba. Yeah, and, that's my favorite instrument, you know.
You like the marimba better than the piano. Is that right?
Yeah, I took lessons when I was 7. I took piano lessons, but I don't want to practice. I don't like the piano. It seems that, you know, I cannot coordinate with my left hand and right hand. So my mom wants me to learn a different instrument, and I heard the marimba in our school where when I was in elementary grade, and then I loved that instrument. I loved the sound of the marimba, so that's what I learned. You know, that's what I chose, and I really love that instrument until I became professional marimba player in the Philippines, and I performed for the military troops.
Wow!
And then we went to Vietnam to entertain the troops from 1969 to 1970.
Wow!
It's a wonderful experience for me to be there, you know, watching the war and also entertaining our troops in Vietnam. And I have lots of good friends in Vietnam. You know, they're all wonderful to me. And
what is there a favorite song? Is there a favorite piece of music that you love the most, or that you always find yourself falling back to?
You mean when I was in Vietnam?
No,
or now?
Now.
Now, there are some that I really like to play. You
What's your favorite?
I play, one of my favorites is, you know, the theme from Man from Snowy River. Jessica Swim. Yeah, I love that song.
Huh. I'll have to look that up. I remember that was a movie, wasn't it?
Yes, Man from Snowy River.
And has it one last question, and then we'll go have some fun. Has your choice in songs changed since you've become ill?
Well, I learn different music now, you know. Ever since I had my surgery, you know, I try to listen to different music. You know, like the music from the Phantom of the Opera, or you know, songs by Adele.
So you're learning new current things.
And I like it too, you know. I learn it just by listening, not by reading notes. I don't read notes. And you know, I just listen to it.
Play by ear. You play by ear.
Yes.
All the time.
All the time. I could read a few lines.
Yeah.
But
that's what I wish I could do, Juan. That's what I wish I could do.
Yeah, you can do it. Yeah, just relax.
And just relax.
Enjoy and do it gradually, little by little. Don't rush to learn the song right away, but you have to enjoy it.
Let it happen.
Let it happen. Listen to it several times and you'll make it.
All right.
Let's just have one last question. You know, when people are, you know, at your work and they're enjoying it, do they ever come over? I mean, how can you tell that when people are enjoying your work? You can tell Eric about it if you would, but well, is it their face? How do you know?
Yes, every time they pass by the piano, they smile at me, they wave at me. Yeah, many people are doing that, you know. They look at me, they smile at me, and
you know.
Yeah.
That's awesome.